On a bitter cold day, two bitter rivals go head-to-head. Division III basketball from Swarthmore College. The 15th-ranked Garnet hosts 12th-ranked Johns Hopkins. The top two teams in the conference fight for the top spot today from Tarble Pavilion on the campus of Swarthmore College. Welcome to the broadcast. I'm Jeff Skaversky. The game pushed back 2 hours today due to snow, but it is worth the wait. These two rivals have battled in each of the last three conference championship games. Today, playoff positioning on the line. Swarthmore College has had Johns Hopkins number of late, including earlier this month, with a win down in Baltimore, and what a win that was. Vinny D'Angelo and George Visconti led the Garnet with 18 points, and Aiden Godfrey, the freshman, added 13, and Godfrey will be in the starting lineup for the first time in his career today. Speaking of the lineups, let's look how things shake out. First, for 12th-ranked Johns Hopkins, the Blue Jays coming in at 14-2 overall. The team from Baltimore, they're going to go with Connor Delaney, Ethan Bartlett, Sidney Thibel, Tom Querrey, and Carson James under head coach Josh Leffler. As far as the home team, in their home whites, 15th-ranked sophomore, the Garnet, they're going to go with George Visconti, Connor Harkins, Michael Caprice, Ryan Ingram, and the freshman, Aiden Godfrey, who came off the bench to score 13 points in their last matchup against Johns Hopkins. The 6'8 freshman getting the start today for head coach Landry Kosmalski in his ninth season, best winning percentage in school history. And we have a matchup today that will likely determine who wins a top spot in the Centennial. Swarthmore comes in 9-2 in the conference, looking to keep that going. And they hit a bit of a rough patch. Look, they're trying to go to the NCAA tournament for the fifth time. They've hit a bit of a rough patch. They've lost a season high two straight games coming into play after starting the season 15-16. Now, Swarthmore, they have won five of the last six meetings against Johns Hopkins, including earlier this month down in Baltimore by nine. That's where Godfrey came up big. That's where Vinny D'Angelo came up big. D'Angelo will come off the bench today. A look at Johns Hopkins. They have two players with local ties, Connor Delaney and Tom Querrey, both from the area. Querrey's from Philadelphia, went to Father Judge High School. Delaney from Garnet Valley, Pennsylvania, and Episcopal Academy. We are set to get underway here from the Tarble Pavilion on the campus of Swarthmore College. Johns Hopkins in their road blue uniforms. They have five straight wins coming into play. Their last loss to this very Swarthmore team back on January 11th. Jeff Skaversky with the broadcast. Today, on a snowy afternoon in the Philadelphia area, the game's pushed back. The women we saw here earlier losing to Johns Hopkins. The men trying to come out victorious today against their rivals in Johns Hopkins. So it's Carson James, as well as Michael Caprice at the center circle. And it'll be Swarthmore coming away with it. This is Ryan Ingram controlling things out of the gate for Swarthmore. Caprice down in the post. Trying to get on the board early. Goes up with the left, gets it to fall. Michael Caprice, the 6'6" sophomore forward, getting Swarthmore on the board, an early start for Garnet. This is a wide open Ethan Bartlett three off the mark. Connor Harkins comes up with the rebound. But off his hands, it'll be Johns Hopkins ball. Just about a minute gone here in the first half. Here's Delaney off the screen. Down low to Thibel. Can't get it to go. Sidney Thibel too hard off the glass. And here comes Swarthmore looking to advance on their early lead. Visconti behind the back. Nice pass there. goes down low, denied is Michael Capriz. Carson James pulls back out. Thibault on the post. Bounce pass, really nice job there to Tom Querrey. Cannot bring it in. Johns Hopkins wanted the foul. They won't get it. Pushing tempo, Swarthmore early on here at home. Looking to end their two-game losing streak. Visconti around the screen, fires up the six-footer. Can't get it to go. His own rebound, put back, can't get that to go. Pass denied by Bartlett. 15 to shoot. Aiden Godfrey can't get it to fall. Bartlett. Out to James. High arcing three. Can't get it to go down. Thibault trying to bat it away. And this is Visconti and Swarthmore. Godfrey. A little too long of a shot for him. He'll give it up. 10 to shoot. Three on the clock. Capriz. And a bad offensive set there by Swarthmore. The Garnet could not get anything going there. Good defense by the Blue Jays. And they are really good defensively. Johns Hopkins comes into this game ranked 12th in the country. They have a one-game lead in the conference over Swarthmore. And they lead the conference in rebounds per game and scoring defense. And we saw that defense go to work there. Ubash Shalah checks into the game, getting his first minutes for Swarthmore. Thibault on the post. Baseline, up and under, gets it to go. The cousin of 76ers guard Matisse Thibault getting Johns Hopkins on the board. We're tied at two. Capriz firing a three, no. Shalah, their defensive specialist, creating some havoc here for Johns Hopkins. Thibault trying to get a pass in, cannot, takes it himself, goes up off the glass too hard, brought down by Capriz. And here comes Swarthmore. Bad pass by Capriz. Shalah was not paying attention there, did not see it coming. And we have a whistle. Just about 4 minutes gone here in the first. We are knotted at two. Slow start by both teams offensively. That is the first team foul on Swarthmore. So Carson James goes to the line. Their junior guard, 6'2", 170 pounds. James has started all 16 games along with Delaney, Thibault, and Bartlett. They have pretty much their same guys in the starting lineup night in and night out. Where Swarthmore, they like to rotate guys, as we talked about, Aiden Godfrey getting his first start of the season today. He performed really well in that last matchup against Johns Hopkins, so he's getting another start today. Another different lineup for Landry Kosmelski. He knocks down his second shot, and Johns Hopkins takes a one-point lead early on here from Swarthmore College. Colin Shaw checks into the game, along with D'Angelo. Vinny D'Angelo, off-balance shot, can't get it to fall. Out of bounds, slow start by Swarthmore. They are 1-for-6 to start from this game. So Harkins remains in the game. In comes Vinny D'Angelo, their sophomore guard, the reigning D3Hoops.com National Rookie of the Year, in the game off the bench for Garnet. Driving in the lane is Lincoln Yiter. He can't get it to fall. Here comes D'Angelo, loses control of the ball, perhaps batted away there. And they are running and gunning. Lincoln Yeider in and out on a three attempt. George Corzine, who just checks into the game. He goes to the work. He hits the deck. We have a foul on the play. The foul will be against Chid Naka. Michael Caprice checks back into the game. Ubash Shalak comes out. The defensive specialist now out of the game. Visconti going to work on the baseline. Goes up around traffic, gets it to fall. And they're back in front up 4-3. Carson James to a wide open Chid Naka, who knocks it down. Caprice off the glass, gets it to go. Michael Caprice, the 6'6" sophomore forward. He has come out strong here to start this game against Johns Hopkins. Carson James around the high screen, looking for a pass inside, doesn't have it. Brendan Johnson in the game for Johns Hopkins. Here comes Yeider, off the glass, gets the scoop. Ooh. And incidental contact there. Michael Caprice and Colin Shaw collide. They both get up, they are okay. Corzine, top of the key. Firing is D'Angelo, short of the three, had the pass tipped away. Braden Johnson steps into a three, can't get it to fall. Swarthmore down one, 6 minutes gone here in the first. Visconti, double team, kicks it out to Corzine. Corzine, an open three, a little outside his range. Caprice going to work down low, using his big physical 6'6" frame to try to make something happen in the post and draw the foul. He does just that. Second team foul against Johns Hopkins. So Shaw and Corzine come out for Swarthmore. Godfrey back in, along with D'Angelo after a quick break. And Kozmowski, he likes to go 10, 11 deep. We're seeing that so far today. Aiden Godfrey, double team. D'Angelo will set things back up. 10 on the shot clock, D'Angelo drives. Out to Visconti, three, rims out. That would have given them a 2-point lead. Instead, here comes Johns Hopkins. This is Delaney. Thibault goes to work in the lane, and he's going to get called for the charge. Sidney Thibault, the junior forward, using that big 6'8", 240 frame to bull his way in. A little too hard there. Good job defensively by Swarthmore to draw that charge. Sidney Thibault, the cousin of Sixers guard Matisse Thibault. He leads the team and is tied fourth in the conference with 1.3 blocks per game. Shoots over 50% from the field. A really good presence down low. But Swarthmore will take it. Caprice, the give and go with Godfrey. Godfrey fires up the shot, gets it to go. Aiden Godfrey. The freshman gets his first two, and Swarthmore back in front. Delaney thinking three, fakes, and they will set back up. Bartlett with 15 to shoot. Thibault looking for a pass. Yeider to Thibault, and he is fouled by Godfrey. that'll go against Godfrey, his first, team second. Sydney Thibel goes to the line, shooting two. About 12 minutes to go here in the first half between 15th-ranked Swarthmore and 12th-ranked Johns Hopkins. Swarthmore trying to go to the NCAA tournament for the fifth time. They've had a bit of a rough patch. They've lost the season high two straight games after winning 15 of 16 to start the season. Thibel puts him in front by one. Ingram back in the game. Harkins to a wide open Caprice. He had a shot at a three. Didn't take it. Here's Harkins for three. No. Rebound Godfrey. Good job in the post there, but wrestled away by Ethan Bartlett. And here come the Blue Jays. Delaney trying to get it in down low to Thibel. And it is kicked. Checking back in will be Ubas Sala, who has a team-high 17 steals, a lot of minutes off the bench, a defensive specialist for Garnet. So Blue Jays ball, 22 on the shot clock. Connor Delaney around traffic with numbers. The Thibel, who slams it down with authority. Sydney Thibel, the cousin of Sixers guard Matisse Thibel, giving the Blue Jays their largest lead. They're up three. Shaw trying to answer. He's denied. Offensive rebound by Harkins. He cannot hold on to it. Here comes Johns Hopkins. A shot to extend their lead. 9 minutes gone here in the first. And the steal by Ingram. All alone, gets it to go. Ryan Ingram, the 6 foot senior guard. He has started all 19 games so far for Garnet, coming up big there. They're within one. Bartlett down low to Thibel. Thibel going to work on Godfrey. Can't get it to go. Good defense by Aiden Godfrey. And here comes Swarthmore, a chance to go back in front. Aiden Godfrey knocks down the three. And Swarthmore up 13-11, early lead here, just about 10 minutes going in the first. James off balanced. And Johns Hopkins wanted a foul on the play, and they get it. So the foul's on Ryan Ingram, the senior guard. More substitutions for Swarthmore. Back comes Vinny D'Angelo. He checks back into the game. This is James. Tight defense on him. James drives in traffic, dishes down low. Nice move inside by Naka. We have a foul on the play. So Caprice called for the foul. Chid Naka goes to the line. The 6'6", 240-pound senior forward. He's at the line shooting two. Naka, their best field goal shooter, 63.5% on the season. Godfrey back in the game after a quick break. And we see that rotation by Kozmalski trying to keep his guys fresh. Vinny D'Angelo back in the game, driving to his left, goes up with it too hard off the glass, and it's out of bounds. It's gonna stay here. Johns Hopkins saying it's off them. They're pleading their case with the referees, but it will be Swarthmore ball. Vinny D'Angelo was going to inbound it. Instead, it'll be George Visconti on the baseline, 20 on the shot clock. Matt Mulvey in the game, Firing is Visconti from the corner, got a three. George Visconti knocks down the three. And they have their largest lead, up four. 9:30 to go here in the first. And we have a charge called against Chidnaka, the senior forward, a little too aggressive. Down low, inside. And Swarthmore about to take charge of this game here early on. 9:29 to go. Will Sykes checking in the game for Johns Hopkins. Here's Visconti going to work, loses the ball. Now fighting for it on the baseline. And it always seems to find the new guy. Will Sykes wrestling for the ball there in that number 44 blue jersey for Johns Hopkins. So Swarthmore and Johns Hopkins have met in the last three conference championships. Swarthmore lost two of three. Their lone W, 2019, when they went to the NCAA tournament, Division III national runners-up this year. And they're trying to repeat. That's Lincoln Leiter missing on the three. And here's Swarthmore pushing tempo. Matt Mulvey, floater, got it. The freshman guard, Matt Mulvey, knocking down two. They're up six. Connor Delaney trying to answer for Johns Hopkins. Around the baseline, pulls back out on Godfrey. And we have a whistle. It's going to go against Swarthmore. It's on Visconti. Ryan Ingram checks back in the game. Matt Mulvey comes out after hitting that shot. And it looks like a hockey line change here. Landry Kosmowski looks more like a hockey coach here with all the changes back and forth. In any event, Swarthmore up six. It's working to their advantage early on here. The handoff to Ethan Bartlett, too hot to handle, and a turnover by the Blue Jays. Ubash Shala, he's back in the game, running the point, along with George Corzine. Corzine sets the pick. Ingram down low to Corzine. He's going to work, can't handle the ball, tries to fight for it on Bartlett, falls into him, and here come the Jays. Delaney to the corner. Yiter can't get it to fall. Under eight to go in the first half. Visconti driving, goes up with it, denied. He is fouled on the play by Ethan Bartlett, the senior guard, fouling George Visconti, who will go to the line shooting two. So that is their sixth-team foul. So George Visconti goes to the line, the 6'3" junior guard shooting two. He had 18 points in their last matchup against Johns Hopkins. He has started all 19 games along with Harkins and Ingram. But certainly, Landry Kosmowski is not afraid to go to his bench. He goes 10-11 deep today. He's going 12-13 deep as Colin Shaw gets set to check back in. Visconti hits one of two, extending their lead to seven. 7:35 to go here in the half. And we have a whistle. That's going to go against Ubash Shala. He's going to pick up his 16th foul for Swarthmore. Visconti will take a breather after hitting the free throw. Swarthmore up seven. Looking to win both games this season against their rivals, Johns Hopkins. Thibault back in the game for the Blue Jays. Thibault going to work down in the post on Corzine. Goes up, falls to the deck, can't get it to fall, and he picks up a foul. So Sidney Thibault will go back to the line, shooting two. George Corzine picks up the foul. Their seventh. Corzine has started 10 of their 18 games. Coming into play, he picks up a foul. Some early foul trouble here in the first half. Sidney Thibault airballs the free throw and a harsh reaction from the Swarthmore bench. This game originally scheduled for 3 o'clock, pushed back 2 hours to 5 due to the snow outside. Without fans being permitted in here at the Tarble Pavilion, I hope you're enjoying the broadcast from home. Nice and cozy, I'm sure. Give me some hot chocolate, coffee going on a cold day here in the Philadelphia area. Corzine fakes. Goes up left-handed after the spin, gets it to fall over Thibault. And Swarthmore extends their lead. They're up 9, their largest lead of the day. You can feel the intensity building here from the Swarthmore bench. Query, good ball movement here. Wide open Connors, Query takes it. And he has fouled on the three-point attempt. So Tom Query, the 6'7" senior forward from Philadelphia and Father Judge High School, he will go to the line. The foul is on Shala, his second, team 8. Query, their second leading scorer on the team, averaging just over 13 points per game. He's their best three-point shooter, despite his large 6'7" frame. Also their best free throw shooter, shooting 86.5% from the line. And more substitutions for both squads. Thibault comes out for Johns Hopkins, and a massive line change for Swarthmore. Query hits both shots from the free throw line. They're within 7. Off the glass is Matt Mulvey, the freshman guard, extending their lead back to 9. Here's Query going to work in the post, draws a double team down low to a wide open Will Sykes. Sykes off the bench, picking up his first 2 points for Johns Hopkins. Mulvey driving inside, throws up the fade, can't get it to fall, rebound Sykes. And here come the Blue Jays on the run, pushing tempo. James thinking about driving there on Shaw. Gets the screen, fires a 3, James knocks it down. Carson James, the junior guard, and we have a timeout. Johns Hopkins calling the timeout after the 3 by Carson James. James has started all 17 games for the Blue Jays. Johns Hopkins trailing by 4, under 6 to go here in the first. Swarthmore's 9-point lead now down to 4. Vinny D'Angelo back in the game along with Aiden Godfrey. The give and go, we have a whistle. A lot of fouls early on in this first half as Harkins gets set to check back in this game.
Hunter Harkins back in for Colin Shaw. He'll take a seat, a breather, for Swarthmore. Last time these two teams met here at Swarthmore College, the conference championship game 2 years ago. Godfrey has Sykes on him, thinking about driving. He does, goes up with it, fires right-handed, can't get it to fall, but he picks up the foul on Sykes. That'll be the seventh team foul against Johns Hopkins. After a quick breather, Ryan Ingram gets set to check back in. He's 6 foot senior guard. So here's Aiden Godfrey at the line, shooting two. Gets the first shot to fall. He came off the bench to score 13 points in their last matchup against Johns Hopkins. That was a game where Vinny D'Angelo and George Visconti led the Garnet with 18 points. They overcome a 10-point deficit in the first half. Quite a comeback, and that really set the tempo for this team facing one of the best teams in the country. Godfrey gets the friendly home roll off the rim, and they extend their lead back up to six. James driving, pulls back out as he does not have leverage. Trying to feed Thibault, and Thibault showing some frustration there at the refs. He wanted a foul on the play. So a warning against Blue Jays head coach Josh Leffler. He is no stranger to this campus. He graduated from here back in 2003. What a start to his career at Johns Hopkins. He's won 80 of his 100 games, ranked second in school history in wins. Leffler has led Johns Hopkins to two conference titles. That is Connor Harkins firing from three. And Swarthmore back up nine, matching their largest lead just under 5 minutes to go here in the half. Delaney around the screen, does not have numbers, pulls back out, 12 to shoot. Connor Delaney going to work on Harkins. Trying to drive, fires up the high arcing shot, can't get it to go, rebound, Corzine. Here comes Swarthmore. D'Angelo thinking three, drives, scoops, picks up the foul. So Vinny D'Angelo will go to the line, shooting two, eighth foul against Johns Hopkins, and Josh Leffler showing his frustration after that bench warning. He is not happy as his 12th-ranked Johns Hopkins Blue Jays are in some trouble early on here, down nine, as Vinny D'Angelo goes to the line. He had 18 points in that last matchup against Johns Hopkins. The Aston, Pennsylvania native who went to Sun Valley knocks down the shot from the free throw line, extending the lead to 10. What a career Vinny D'Angelo is having to start. He's just a sophomore, the reigning Division III Hoops.com National Rookie of the Year. He's also the Conference Rookie of the Year and the Mid-Atlantic Rookie of the Year as well. Off to a great start coming off the bench today. He knocks down his second shot, hitting both from the free throw line. He will check back out. They're up 11, largest lead of the day for Swarthmore. Four and change to go here in the first half. Jeff Skaversky on the call here from Swarthmore College. Swarthmore in their home whites, and Johns Hopkins in their road blue uniforms. Connor James, open three, no good. Shaw the rebound, and here comes Garnett. Shaw goes up with it, can't get it to fall, and it goes off of Thibault and Query. It'll stay Garnett ball. So everything going Garnett's way here. Go off 20 on the shot clock, under four to go. Rim on the inbound to Harkins. Harkins has a tight defense on him. Trying to cross over his defender. Gets in the lane, pulls back out. Shaw now with 10 to shoot. Corzine, top of the key. Ingram hits it from three. They're up 14. Number 14 puts Swarthmore up 14. Their largest lead of the day, 3:20 to go in the half. You can feel the intensity building here. Connor Delaney, high arcing three. He wanted the foul, didn't get it. Shaw. Here's Visconti, the three, off the back of the iron. Horzine fighting for the rebound, out of bounds. It'll be Blue Jays ball. And the Swarthmore bench with a lot of intensity right now as Horzine, he'll check back out. Back comes Aiden Godfrey. Top two programs in the Centennial Conference battling it out here. Swarthmore with a shot to overtake Johns Hopkins for the top spot in the league. With an early first half lead here, they're up 14. Delaney down low to Fornaca, can't handle it. They keep it in. Query thinking three, drives, kicks it out. Connor Delaney, three, hits the deck and hits the shot. And now Connor Delaney with a shot for a four-point play at the line. The Garnet Valley, Pennsylvania native and Episcopal Academy grad, he will go to the line. A shot at a four-point play and potentially a huge swing there for Johns Hopkins. Delaney, quite a story. Originally committed to go to Villanova to play lacrosse. He changed his mind, decided he wanted to play basketball instead, and that is a good decision. One of the best players in school history has scored over 1,000 points, and he knocks down the free throw to get the Blue Jays within 10. A four-point play there by Johns Hopkins. And perhaps the break the Blue Jays needed there as things were starting to pull away there. Swarthmore up as many as 14. 2:36 to go here in the half. Garnet up 10. And the refs will talk it over. Either of these teams played last year due to COVID. Last time they actually played, 2020. And Swarthmore was about to get set for a Sweet 16 appearance when it was canceled due to COVID. They're hoping to get back to the NCAA tournament this year. Here's Visconti through traffic, and he's called for the charge. So just when it looked like Swarthmore was pulling away with this first half lead, they've hit a bit of an ice patch. Salah checks back in the game. Visconti will take a seat, a breather here with 2:22 to go in the half. Connor Delaney off his four-point play. Looks to cut into this deficit. Delaney has Salah on him, the defensive specialist for Swarthmore. And wow, good defensive stand there by Ubas Salah, their defensive specialist. Comes in to make a defensive stand. He does just that. He'll check back out. A team high 17 steals. And he gets Connor Delaney to pick up the offensive foul. So 19 fouls combined between both of these teams so far in the first half. Under two to go here in the first half. D'Angelo thinking three, drives off the glass, can't get it to go. Query thinking three. James loses the ball as he goes around the screen, and we have yet another foul. So now both teams with 10 fouls. The referees blowing the whistle nonstop so far in the first half. Colin Shaw, the 6'3" junior guard, he gets set to check back in for Swarthmore. Carson James goes to the line, their junior guard for Johns Hopkins, a team from Baltimore, Maryland, looking to cut into their deficit here with 93 seconds to go here in the half. Matt Mulvey back in the game for Swarthmore. James hits his second free throw. And Hopkins within 8. Ooh. And Vinny D'Angelo trips. He looked back at the ref for a foul. He didn't get it. So Vinny D'Angelo gets up with a smirk on his face, wondering, hey, where was that foul? And the referee's now talking it over. So the floor perhaps a little slippery. They will mop it down as we have a little break in the action here. 1:24 to go in the half. 33-24, Swarthmore in front. Ranked Swarthmore, 15-3 record coming in, 9-2 in the Centennial Conference, looking to add to those totals today. They've been in control most of this first half. And Josh Leffler, who already got a bench warning earlier, the head coach of Johns Hopkins, giving the referees more lip here in this first half. Godfrey going to work in the post on Thibel. He gets double teamed. Out to Shaw. Fakes three. Steps in and knocks it down. Colin Shaw steps into a shot there. He has 6 points here in the first half. Sidney Thibel up and under. Can't get it to go. He draws a foul. That'll be the 11th foul on Swarthmore here in the first half. It'll go against Aiden Godfrey, the freshman making his first start of the season today. He had that great game the last time out a few weeks ago against Johns Hopkins. Thibault can't get his first to fall. And more substitutions for both sides. George Corzine, the 6'7" junior forward, checks back in for Swarthmore. Vinny D'Angelo remains on the floor. Thibel hits one of two, and it's back to a 10-point game, under a minute to go here in the half. D'Angelo on the left side going to work. Fires a three. Vinny D'Angelo knocking down a three. Connor Delaney answers for Johns Hopkins. And Josh Leffler calls a timeout. Connor Delaney answering with a three, back to a 10-point game, 34.4 seconds to go here in the half. Seconds to go here in the half between Swarthmore and Johns Hopkins. Barnett with a 10-point lead and the ball here. Here's Harkins on the baseline. Hopkins a full court press. Swarthmore gets it out of their own zone. They beat the press and they will set up here. 3-second differential between the clocks. D'Angelo looking like he's going to hold for one here. Going to let the shot clock wind down, 10 to shoot. Vinny D'Angelo with the ball, going to work on Carson James. Gets a screen, fires a three, off the glass and in. Vinny D'Angelo with back-to-back threes for Swarthmore. And they're up 13. And a prayer at the buzzer. Connor Delaney is denied, and that'll do it for the first half. Swarthmore in front, 41-28, a 13-point lead at the half. I'm Jeff Skaversky. We're back with halftime stats after this from Swarthmore College.
Across divisions, sports, championships, and schools, for nearly half a million student athletes, college sports create lifelong opportunity, and that starts with education. We've raised the academic bar so more are earning degrees, creating healthier campuses by working with the nation's brightest minds, and making sure more have the chance to succeed and are supported on their journey. But beyond the numbers, it's about opportunity, and we're working to provide it for every student athlete.
It's not about where you were born. It's not about your gender. Or the color of your skin. Or whether you're rich, poor, or in the middle. No matter what you play, if you have the skill and drive to succeed in school and in sports, we'll provide the opportunity.
On and off the court, we're focused on creating lifelong opportunity, and that starts with education. More college athletes are earning degrees than ever before, but we've still got work to do. That's why we're raising the bar for incoming freshmen, so they're prepared when they get to campus, and why teams can't play in championships unless they make the grade. Education matters, and putting academics first creates a pathway to a lifetime of opportunity.
Vinny D'Angelo, their leading scorer here at Swarthmore, leading the way off the bench, 8 points so far. In the first half, he is a perfect 2-for-2 from beyond. He has Swarthmore up 13, 41-28 here at the half. Jeff Skaversky bringing you the broadcast from Tarble Pavilion on the campus of Swarthmore College here in Delaware County. Inside the first half numbers, and Swarthmore shooting lights out, especially from beyond. 54.5% from three, shooting over 48% from the floor in this game. And their defense has been absolutely tremendous on Johns Hopkins, holding them to 36%. Leading the way for Johns Hopkins is Delaney, Thibault, and James, each with seven. Aiden Godfrey in the starting lineup, making his first career start here at Swarthmore, the freshman, has 7 points, the second leading scorer so far for Swarthmore. Up as many as 14, they have a 13-point halftime lead. We're back with the second half after this from Swarthmore College. Swarthmore, 20 minutes away from ending their two-game losing streak. I'm Jeff Skaversky back here at Swarthmore College as the Garnet with a 13-point lead here at the half against the Blue Jays. Swarthmore and Johns Hopkins, the top two defensive programs in the Centennial Conference in points allowed per game. And so far, so good for Swarthmore's defense, holding Johns Hopkins only 36% from the floor and only 27% from beyond. And they will need that defense here today with that 13-point lead as we get set to start the second half here from this gorgeous campus here in Delaware County, Pennsylvania. Aiden Godfrey in the starting lineup, making his first career starts. He has 7 points. Leading the way is Vinny D'Angelo off the bench with 8. He has knocked down both of his 3-point attempts. So it'll be Johns Hopkins in their road blues. They will start here with the ball, with possession, to start the second half. And second half underway here from Swarthmore College. Jeff Skaversky calling the action as Swarthmore looks to end their two-game losing streak. Connor Delaney fires a 3, offensive rebound. Thibel, Bartlett, corner, no. Thibel trying to keep it in. Harkins comes down with the rebound, and here comes Swarthmore, wide open. Visconti can't get the 3 to fall. And pushing tempo are the Blue Jays here early. Delaney driving, loses it, pulls back out. And he'll set back up, looking for their opening points here in the second half. Delaney off the dribble, kicks it out to James. James can't get it to go. Minute gone here in the half. Swarthmore can add to their lead. This is Godfrey. Going to work on Bartlett. Godfrey throws it up. Can't get it to fall off the back of the iron. But both teams coming out cold. The give and go. Thibel is denied as he hits the ground. All ball there by Aiden Godfrey on the block. Sidney Thibel. He had that dunk early in the first half using that big 6'8", 240-pound frame. 21 on the shot clock for the Blue Jays. James around traffic. Delaney goes to work, drives inside. Visconti denies him. Here's Godfrey from 3. Knocks it down. Aiden Godfrey. In his first career start, he has 10 points. He now leads the way for Swarthmore. They're in front, 44-28. Thibel going to work on Godfrey. Goes up with it, gets it to fall. Sidney Thibel adding 2 more to his total. He now has 9. Swarthmore up 14. Caprice thinking 3. He now goes inside. Visconti drives in the lane, goes under Bartlett, trying to go up with it, does just that, can't get it to fall. And they fight for a rebound. It's going to go other way. 2:30 gone here in the second half. Swarthmore in front, 44-30. Colin Shaw checks back in for George Visconti. He'll take a seat along with Aiden Godfrey. Swarthmore looking to end their two-game losing streak. They've hit a bit of a rough patch in this season as Carson James gets it to go off the glass. Swarthmore's lead down to a dozen. George Corzine back in the game. Here's Shaw off the screen, has Bartlett on him. Ingram. Harkins now, 9 to shoot. Harkins, hook shot, no. Bartlett thinking three, fakes, pulls back out, and they'll set back up. 20 on the shot clock. Here's their star point guard, Connor Delaney. With a little mismatch, drives in the lane, throws it up, hits the deck, can't get it to fall. And Delaney's slow to get up. His second trip down the floor where he's hit the deck underneath the basket there. So Connor Delaney will go to the line. He was named Conference Player of the Week. He leads the conference with 19.6 points per game, and he goes to the line moving gingerly. Looks like he's a little bit in pain there as he goes to the line. The Garnet Valley, Pennsylvania native from Episcopal Academy, the 6-foot, 175-pound guard. He hits his first to get Johns Hopkins back within 11. Delaney's having an unbelievable season. Opened the year with back-to-back 30-point games. And when they couldn't play last year, he actually walked onto the lacrosse team last spring when basketball was canceled. Played every game, finished second on the team in ground balls for that Division I-ranked lacrosse team at Johns Hopkins that year in and year out is nationally ranked. So he hits both free throws, and all of a sudden, the 13-point halftime lead is down to 10 for Swarthmore. Matt Mulvey back in the game. Hands it off to Harkins. Good ball movement on the perimeter here by Swarthmore. Mulvey driving through traffic. Three to shoot. Fires it up. Can't get it to go. Rebound. Capriz. He's wrestling for it. Out to Mulvey. Three. Short. And Chid Naka, who checked back into the game, pulls down the rebound. James goes left-handed, gets it to fall. It's an 8-point lead. D'Angelo too hard after off the glass. Johns Hopkins with a little momentum here. They have cut this deficit to 8. Query, three, got it. Tom Query, the Philadelphia native and Father Judge High School grad, knocks down the three, and this lead is down to 44-39. It is a 5-point game just like that. Johns Hopkins comes out from the half, and they're on a run, and a wise decision here to call a timeout by Swarthmore head coach Landry Kosmowski. We're back after this. So Johns Hopkins opens the second half on an 11-3 run, and Landry Kosmowski, the head coach of Swarthmore, wisely calling a timeout. They'll try to regroup here. Shala checks back into the game, their defensive specialist. Godfrey has it stripped. And Swarthmore is leaking oil right now. So a 14-point lead in the first half is down to 5 as Salah picks up a foul, their third of the half. Harkins checks out. Back in comes Michael Capriz. Johns Hopkins can make it a one-possession game here. Connor Delaney off the high screen, drives off the glass, got it. It's a 3-point game. 14-3 run by Johns Hopkins to start the second half. Mulvey in the lane. Out to Ingram. Off the mark. Johns Hopkins can tie it with a three. James thinking three. James now working on the baseline. Goes around the D. Out to Leiter, who's in the game. Leiter, the low pass to Thibault off his shin and out. A turnover by Johns Hopkins and their lone mistake of the half. And perhaps Swarthmore can regroup and capitalize on this turnover. Just about 6 minutes gone here in the half. Hopkins with the full court press. Capriz and Swarthmore beat it. Wide open, D'Angelo three, no. Here's Bartlett with numbers. Drives off the glass too hard, rebound Godfrey. And here comes Vinny D'Angelo and Swarthmore, coast to coast. The soft kiss off the glass, D'Angelo gets it to fall. And perhaps the boost they need as Swarthmore is trying to do damage control here in the second half. James throws it up, no good. Godfrey the rebound. Here comes Vinny D'Angelo again. Finger roll, got it. Vinny D'Angelo, back-to-back shots for Swarthmore, the 15th ranked Garnet. Trying to go 16-3 on the season. And that forces Josh Loeffler to call a timeout for Johns Hopkins. Swarthmore up seven. So Swarthmore clinging to a 7-point lead, trying to do damage control here in the second half. Up 13 at the half. Johns Hopkins came out red hot to start the second. And Swarthmore has answered with back-to-back layups by Vinny D'Angelo, their leading scorer. Delaney will set up here, fires a three. Off the mark. Thibault fighting for a rebound. And the ref says he stepped on the baseline. So it'll be Swarthmore ball. Just about 13 minutes to go here in the second half. Salah back in the game for Swarthmore. Godfrey goes to work on Bartlett. Draws a double team. Good ball movement here. Ryan Ingram cannot connect from three. And here comes Yiter and Johns Hopkins. Johns Hopkins, 12th ranked team in the country, 14-2 overall. The team from Baltimore, Maryland. And Sidney Thibault, an easy two. As Harkins hit the ground there. And they wanted the offensive foul. They did not get it. Michael Capriz is pleading with the referee, asking, hey, what happened there? But Sidney Thibault using his muscle, that 6'8", 240-pound frame, to knock down the shot. And they're within five here. Swarthmore trying to stop the bleeding. Visconti off the screen, in rhythm, knocks down the two from the elbow. Their lead extended to seven. So George Visconti picks up the foul. That'll be his third, team fourth of the half. 20 on the shot clock. A little less than 12 minutes to go here in the half from Swarthmore College in Delaware County. Connor Delaney around the defense, goes baseline, tries to go up and under. He's denied by Godfrey. A fight for the ball. Godfrey down there, loose ball. Finally, Ingram comes down with it. And you could feel the intensity building here between these two programs. These two rivals, the top two teams in the conference. Johns Hopkins, the one seed. Swarthmore, the two seed. Swarthmore trying to overtake their rivals for the top spot in the Centennial Conference. These two teams have met in back-to-back-to-back conference championship games. Swarthmore with a seven-point lead. Here's Vinny D'Angelo. Ingram thinking about driving, pulls back, wide open three. Capriz off the mark. Godfrey pulls down the rebound. Goes back up with it. Off the glass too hard. Capriz rebound. He puts it back. And a second chance point for Michael Capriz and Swarthmore. They're up nine. James trying to get into Thibault. Couldn't do it. Ingram, other end, no. Capriz fighting to go up with it. He is fouled on the play. The foul will be against Carson James. It'll be their second. So Ryan Ingram, the senior guard, inbounded under the baseline. Here's Vinny D'Angelo. D'Angelo has lighter on him. Slips as he drives, and that is going to go against Lincoln Yeiter, their backup junior guard. Yeiter has played just nine games yet to start. He is shooting over 50% from the field. He gets called for the foul there. So once again, it'll be Ryan Ingram under the baseline on the inbounds, 20 to shoot for Swarthmore. Vinny D'Angelo, ball fake, goes up with it, denied by Sidney Thibault. Here come the Blue Jays. Delaney down low to Thibault. He does look like his cousin, Matisse Thibault, the Sixers guard. He can't get it to fall. Rebound Ingram. Swarthmore can extend their lead. Up nine, here's Godfrey. He's blocked from behind and fouled by Sidney Thibault. So Aiden Godfrey, he'll go to the line, shooting two. Godfrey, an 81% free throw shooter, coming into play. The freshman making his first start. He had 13 points back in their last matchup off the bench against Johns Hopkins on their own down in Baltimore. D'Angelo and Harkins, they will take a seat, a quick breather, as Salah and Shaw check back into the game. And now George Corzine, he gets set to check back in for Landry Kosmalski, the head coach for Swarthmore. Kosmalski going 12-13 deep today off the bench using a rotation. Out comes Salah. And it's hard to question what he does with that rotation. Look, five straight conference tournament title games they've been to. He's a four-time coach of the year in the conference, leading the conference to championship games, championships twice. He's done an unbelievable job. Mulvey trying to get into Corzine, couldn't get it to go. Ball movement on the perimeter here, 10 to shoot. Capriz gets it to go off the glass. Michael Capriz extends their lead. They are back up 11. Looking to pull away here in the second half. Connor James wide open off the screen, gets it to fall. They're back within nine. Just about 9.5 to go here from Swarthmore College in Delaware County. Capriz in the lane. Gets the roll over Chidnaka. And Michael Capriz is starting to heat up here. The sophomore forward adding to his total. Naka out to Leiter. Leiter drives, pulls back out. Out to James. James drives, spins, gets the finger roll. Nice move there in the lane. Off the mark, Shaw gets the rebound. He's fighting for it down low, and we have a whistle. It's called off. And Landry Kozmalski pleading with the ref as Godfrey and Harkins check back in the game for Swarthmore. Out comes Naka and Johnson, as well as Winley for Johns Hopkins. Off the screen, Mulvey no from three. Off balance three attempt there. Connor Delaney running point for Johns Hopkins. Here's Delaney trying to cross over Ingram. Three short. Here comes Mulvey with numbers. Throws it up, basket and the foul. And you see the emotion there from the freshman guard, Matt Mulvey. He'll go to the line with a shot at a three-point play and a chance to extend this 11-point lead with eight and change to go here in the half. Matt Mulvey connects from the free throw line, a three-point play by the freshman guard here at Swarthmore. And their lead up to 12, 8:20 to go in the second half. Delaney, nice pass down low to Sydney Thibault, who gets the two off the glass. Ingram to a cutting Saba. Batted away. Here comes Delaney. Through traffic, slices through, can't get it to fall, but draws the foul. So Connor Delaney will go back to the line, shooting two. Delaney leads the conference in scoring, just under 20 points per game. Great free throw shooter. Delaney's shooting nearly 75% from the line. He's been brilliant this year, playing just under 33 minutes a game. Been really been their team leader. Among the reasons Johns Hopkins leads the conference in three-pointers per game. They've won five straight. They haven't lost since that beat against this very Swarthmore team. And Delaney hits both. Azure with an eight. Mulvey fires another three, cannot connect. Blue Jays are running. Trying to get some momentum here in the second half. They came out hot from halftime. And Swarthmore trying to cool them off. Connor Delaney with eight to shoot. Drives, stops, spins, denied. Good defense there by Garnett. Here comes D'Angelo. Harkins, open three, got it. Connor Harkins, the senior guard, knocks down the three. They're back up 11. Delaney thinking three, the give and go to Thybul. Thybul gets it to go off the glass, and the cousin of Sixers guard, Matisse Thybul, knocks down the two, gets Johns Hopkins back within nine. We're back after this. Back here from Swarthmore College, Jeff Skaversky with Swarthmore having a 9-point lead, 6:36 to go here in this game. And Landry Kosmowski, what a job he has done so far in his career at Swarthmore College. Best winning percentage in school history. Named 2020 NABC National Coach of the Year. Team finished ranked number one in the country at 28-1. Primed to make that Sweet 16 run. But that game, of course, canceled due to COVID. That was the last time they were in the NCAA tournament. They're hoping to return to the NCAA tournament this year. This could be another signature win for his program. Mulvey off the glass over Thybul, gets it to go. They're back up 11. Delaney underneath, out to Query, three, no. Philadelphia native can't get it to fall. They get an offensive rebound, and they will get another crack at it, but Carson James' shot bounced off the rim into the shot clock. So a stoppage in action here as Vinny D'Angelo, their leading scorer, checks back in for Swarthmore. It'll be Garnett ball. The 15th ranked Garnett looking to go 16-3 on the season. Last meeting at home against this Johns Hopkins team came in 2020, the conference championship game. Swarthmore lost that game, but they're in position here to get a win today at home. There are no fans allowed here at Swarthmore College inside here at the Tarble Pavilion. They have shut that down with the Omicron variant spreading rapidly. There is some talk. At some point, they'll open it back up to spectators. Too bad there can't be fans here today. It has been an unbelievable game. Aiden Godfrey on the alley-oop attempt. Can't get it to fall, but he draws the foul. The freshman will go to the line, shooting two. Eighth team foul on Johns Hopkins. Ryan Ingram and Salah get set to check back in for Kozmalski and the Swarthmore Garnet. Godfrey hits his first, the freshman making his first career start today after 13 points in that win over Johns Hopkins a few weeks back. He has earned this start. Certainly Kozmalski playing the matchup here today with the freshman, Aiden Godfrey. His second free throw attempt is good, and Colin Shaw checks back in. Godfrey will take a seat after hitting both free throws and extending this lead back up to 13, where it was at the half. So Swarthmore in charge. Connor James finds a double team and an offensive foul underneath the basket. It's going to go against Sydney Thibel, their ninth team foul. Just under 6 minutes to go here in the second half. Swarthmore in front by 13. Looking to end their two-game losing streak. Ingram off the high screen. D'Angelo thinks about feeding it. Instead, keeps it for himself. Can't get it to fall. Offensive rebound. They'll get another crack at it and a fresh 20. Ingram tries to go up with it. It is a jump ball with Thibel. It'll stay down here. It'll be Garnet ball. Lincoln Yeiter checks back in for Johns Hopkins. Arson James will take a seat. Bovey on the inbounds. Out to Vinny D'Angelo. 13 seconds to shoot here. Just over 5 minutes to go in the half. Capri's had an open three. And that is Harkins on the off-balance, high-arcing three. Can't get it to go. We have a whistle and another foul as Chidnaka checks back into the game for Sydney Thibel, who picks up yet another foul. Bolvi's inbound pass, too hot to handle. Michael Capriz could not get his hand on it, out of bounds, and some more substitutions, guys in and out depending on the possession. Talked about it in the first half. It almost feels like a hockey game with all these line changes. Lots of substitutions, but it is working in the favor of Swarthmore College here today at home. Delaney going to work on Salah, their defensive specialist. Salah stayed with their best player there. Ubas Salah has a team high 17 steals coming into play. Gets a lot of minutes off the bench as a defensive specialist. He's not known for scoring, but man, oh man, can number 10 defend the ball or what? Here's Yeiter. He draws Salah, goes to the ground. Yeiter, a bad pass, fight for it underneath through the legs of Salah, and a fresh shot clock for Johns Hopkins as they maintain possession. Laney, three, way off the mark from downtown. Came off the high screen, could not get that three to drop. And Swarthmore will set back up. Godfrey back in the game. Here's Shaw. 10 to shoot. Godfrey on query. Blocked by James. Turnover by Swarthmore. Here comes the Blue Jays. Query fakes three, pulls back, three, got it. Tom Query, the Philadelphia native and Father Judge grad, knocks down the three. It is a 10-point game, just over four to go in the half. 15th-ranked Swarthmore trying to rebound from their loss to Muhlenberg. They lost by 16. An uncharacteristic game for Garnet, trying to bounce back from that loss. And they have a 10-point lead here, 4 minutes, 7 seconds to go against the 12th-ranked Johns Hopkins Blue Jays, who are 14-2 overall in the season. They're off to their best start since 2014-15 season when they went on to the Sweet 16. So it's Swarthmore ball out of the timeout. Blue Jays had the full court press. Godfrey brings it over the timeline, and Swarthmore will set up here with Vinny D'Angelo running the point. D'Angelo backing down lighter. Balls to the ground. They're batting away for it. Turnover by Swarthmore. Here comes Delaney and the Blue Jays. Delaney pulls back. Three. Got it. Connor Delaney, the Garnet Valley native, knocks down the three, and suddenly it's a 7-point game with 3:30 to go. Capriz over Thibault, gets it to go, and Swarthmore quickly answers there. Michael Capriz, their 6'6" sophomore forward, getting it done in the post. Query to the glass. He drives. A quick two for Tom Query, their second leading scorer. Capriz spins inside, denied by Thibault. Under three to go, 7-point game. Swarthmore needs a stop. Query, thinking three, pulls back. Delaney setting up a screen on him. Query goes to his left. Up for the layup, too hard. Rebound, Thibault. Query, corner three, no. Thibault rebound, trying to fight for it. Query saves it. And Johns Hopkins gets another offensive rebound and another shot to cut into this deficit. They're down 7. And we have a whistle. A foul on the play. That'll go against Vinny D'Angelo, the sophomore guard for Swarthmore. Picks up a foul. Team 7. So Connor Delaney will go back to the line for the Blue Jays. The conference player of the week, leading the conference with 19.6. points per game. Delaney, a 75% free throw shooter. It's his first of the one-on-one. Swarthmore won this matchup earlier this month in Baltimore by 9. They overcame a 10-point deficit in the first half. Vinny D'Angelo and George Visconti led the Garnet with 18 points. But Johns Hopkins leads the all-time series 72-37 as they cut into the deficit here today. It's now a 5-point game. Swarthmore trying to stop the bleeding here at home. Final 2 minutes, and Landry Kosmalski calls a timeout. Wise decision here with 2:09 to play. And what was a 13-point lead is down to 5. We're back after this. out of the timeout. Swarthmore up five with the ball. 2:09 to go here in this ball game. Swarthmore trying to end their two-game losing streak, a season high. Trying to advance here at home to 7-2. They've been oh so good here at home. Trying to add to that win total today against their rivals. Vinny D'Angelo off the screen, driving on Query. Off the glass, draws the foul, can't get it to fall. He'll go to the line, shooting two with a smirk on his face. Vinny D'Angelo has a lot to be happy about. 18 points in that last matchup against Johns Hopkins. He leads his team with nearly 17 points per game off the bench, and he is leading things once again today. He has been great for this team. He's a local kid from Aston, Pennsylvania. He went to Sun Valley High School just down the road. He's been really good, the reigning rookie of the year in the conference and nationally in Division III. And he hits his first free throw to give them a six-point lead, 1:56 to go here at home. D'Angelo knocks down his second free throw. They build that seven-point lead, 1:56 to go. Another timeout by Swarthmore as they will talk things over defensively. And they will come back out with Ubas Salah, their defensive specialist, who has a team-high 17 steals coming in. They need a stop here on defense as they're up seven. Earlier today, the Swarthmore women, they lost to Johns Hopkins. It was a tight game early on. A one-point game late in the first half, but Johns Hopkins, too much to handle. They pulled away with a 56-48 win. The Swarthmore men trying to change the story in the nightcap. Both the games today of this doubleheader pushed back 2 hours due to the snow outside, blizzard-like conditions in many parts of the Delaware Valley. But there's no question things are heating up inside here at the Tarble Pavilion on the campus of Swarthmore College in Delaware County. Top two teams in the conference fighting for the top seed here today. Swarthmore with a 7-point lead under 2 minutes to go. Salah, their defensive specialist, looking to make a stand here. Here's Delaney with the ball in that number 5 blue jersey. He drives through traffic, slices through the defense, gets it to go off the glass. It's back to a 5-point game as the Blue Jays apply the full court press, and too hot to handle for Ubas Salah. Could not bring in the pass by Michael Caprice, and a crucial mistake with 1:29 to go. Their lead down to 5, and the Blue Jays can make this a one-possession game here with a 2 or 3. Bartlett's pass picked off. Salah making up for it there. 18 steals on the year. Here's Vinny D'Angelo. High off the glass, too hard. Offensive rebound by Swarthmore. They will set back up with a fresh shot clock and a 1:10 to go here in the game. Visconti pulls back out, loses the ball. Connor Delaney fight for it. They hits the deck. Cross-court pass. Ryan Ingram steps into a shot, knocks it down. It's a 7-point game. Ryan Ingram perhaps saving the day with 52.8 seconds to go. The senior guard coming up big here in the final minute. We have a nail biter here from Swarthmore College in Delaware County. Swarthmore up 7, just under 53 seconds to go in this game, looking to pull off yet another win against their rivals, Johns Hopkins. They beat them earlier this season on the road, and now Swarthmore shot to end their season-high two-game losing streak. They need a defensive stop here as Johns Hopkins looks to cut into this deficit. And we have a whistle here. Referee's trying to decide what's going on. They're saying it was originally against Carson James, and now the referee says, literally, my bad, as Josh Leffler was in his face, upset with the call. So, mistake by the ref. It happens. We're all human. And Connor Delaney fires a long NBA-style three short as he was trying to cut this deficit into a four-point game. And Josh Leffler, wearing his emotions on his sleeve, the former Swarthmore student, now head coach for Johns Hopkins, is not happy. The frustration settling in for Johns Hopkins. George Visconti will go to the line. The 6'3" junior guard, he had 18 points in the last matchup against Johns Hopkins. He has started all 18 games along with Harkins and Ingram. Visconti knocks down the first shot. He's an 80% free throw shooter. His second attempt here. Knocks it down, under 40 seconds to go. Lead back to 9 for Swarthmore, looking to close this out here. They apply the full court press, they back off. Yiter drives off the glass too hard, and that will just about do it as Swarthmore pulls down the rebound, and they will pull off this win with 30 and a half seconds to go here at home. So Ryan Ingram goes back to the line with a minute to go in this game. He came up with a crucial crunch time shot. He stepped in with 2 from the elbow, giving them a 7-point lead. And now he extends their lead once again. Swarthmore up 10. So 15th ranked Swarthmore will go on with an upset here at home against Johns Hopkins, who had won 5 straight coming in. Ingram hits both shots. They're back up 11. Delaney gets the basket and the foul. With 24 seconds to go. But this will be too little, too late. The foul's against Salah. He will come out along with Shaw. So Delaney will go to the line. He'll shoot 1. Looking to make this a 3-point play. He does just that. So that'll just about do it here from Swarthmore College as Vinny D'Angelo is fouled. And they will exchange fouls on the play. Fouls on Carson James as Johns Hopkins will go home losers in the men's game. The women won the first game of the day. And now it'll be Johns Hopkins going down in the nightcap. And we have a technical foul on the play. Been a lot of communication between Leffler and the refs. Not a technical. In any event, it is George Visconti, the junior guard, going to the line. Try to add to the lead here for Swarthmore. Final seconds from Swarthmore College here in Delaware County. Jeff Skaversky calling the action between 12th ranked Johns Hopkins and 15th ranked Visconti knocks down both shots. They are back up 9, 21 seconds to go here in this game. Delaney on a pull off a 3, kicks it out to Query. Query 3, corner, airballs it. It'll stay down on this end with 8.8 to go. We have a timeout by Johns Hopkins. Josh Leffler calls a timeout. He will talk things over. Third down 9, 8.8 seconds to go in this game. And this is certainly not what Johns Hopkins came here to do. They lost to this very Swarthmore Garnet team just a few weeks ago. They were trying to return the favor on Swarthmore's home court here today. It's not going to happen. Swarthmore will advance to 16-3 on the season, 10-2 in the conference. They win both games this season versus their rivals, Johns Hopkins and Landry Kosmalski. What a job he has done in his 9th season. 5 straight conference tournament title games. Looking to make it 6 in a row this season. And you have to wonder, will they see this very Johns Hopkins team once again? They have faced each other in 3 straight conference title games. The last matchup at home between these two was a conference championship game. You have to wonder if this continues to play out, they will go head-to-head for a 4th consecutive season. So back with the action, it'll be Johns Hopkins ball. Leiter under his own basket with the ball, 8.8 to go. Out to Delaney. Thinking 3, steps into 1, and can't get it to fall. Rebound by Capriz, and it'll go the other way as Johns Hopkins continues to foul Swarthmore, who will go back to the line as they look to close this out with 2.1 seconds to go. George Corzine will check back in, the 6'7" junior forward. He has started 10 of their 18 games coming into play, coming off the bench today. Capriz misses his first free throw attempt as Johns Hopkins has 10 team fouls. So Johns Hopkins, they will have their 5-game winning streak come to an end today here at Swarthmore. And that'll just about do it. Query throwing up the prayer, and that is a final. It is 78-68, Swarthmore with the upset. The 15th-ranked Garnet upsetting their rivals from Johns Hopkins. The Blue Jays go down, snapping their 5-game winning streak. So, unbelievable job here today by Landry Kosmalski, the head coach of Swarthmore, getting the job done. It is Garnet winning 78-68, a 10-point win. They advance to 16-3 on the season, 10-2 in the conference. They win both games this year against their rivals, Johns Hopkins. Will they see them again, once again, in the conference championship game? We will find out. Well, that'll do it today from Swarthmore College. It is a wrap from Delaware County and the Tarble Pavilion. I'm Jeff Skaversky from Swarthmore College. It is a final. Swarthmore winning by 10. Good night.